Miss, well, let's speak now to the author of the Labour manifesto, Ed Miliband. Ed Miliband, hello. First of all, Peter Mandelson called the manifesto Blair Plus. Is that a fair description? It sounds like a sort of vitamin supplement.
Well, Peter is Peter. I think the thing I'm interested in is what this says about the future of Labour politics.
But he thinks the future of Labour politics is Blair Plus. What does Blair Plus mean? You presumably are singing from the same hymn
sheet. You'll have to ask him. The thing I think that this
but
tells us...
I'm asking you what Blair Plus is.
Well, let me try and explain. What I think this manifesto shows is that we have responded and learnt from the two great crises we've seen in the last couple of years, the global financial crisis and the political crisis of expenses. And that means three things about our manifesto. First of all, that we need to be bolder in relation to intervening in the market in our economy, and we can talk about that. Secondly, that particularly because of the fiscal pressures we face, we do need to reform our public services, in particular ways building on what we've done. And thirdly, we need to open up politics.
So that is Blair Plus, is it?
Well, I don't know what Blair Plus means, to be honest.
Peter Mandelson is running this campaign. He's your cabinet colleague. And if you don't know what Blair Plus is, he thinks it's Blair Plus.
If you like.
You don't.
If you like.
If you like. Whatever we like. OK. Do you like that, Blair Plus?
Fine. I'm happy with that.
2005 manifesto promised not to raise income tax, and you broke that promise. So why should we believe any tax promises in this manifesto?
Because we've seen a once-in-a-generation global recession.
You think?
And... well, once in a generation. I think it's by common consent this has been a pretty unusual event, and indeed we're taking measures to prevent it happening again. And we faced a decision. We had to make a decision. How do we spread the burden of paying off the deficit? We made a decision that should be focused at the top of the income scale, including by raising the top rate of tax.
But is it not the case at the moment by making any explicit statement on tax in a manifesto as a hostage to fortune? So what happens is you are left uncertainty in a funny way by doing the opposite, because we don't know what you're going to do about VAT, and you haven't ruled out a hike in VAT, have you?
I think it's right that we were consistent with previous manifestos.
But have you ruled out a hike in VAT?
The manifesto is clear. Let me just explain. We've ruled out income tax rates.
So why won't you rule out VAT?
And we've ruled out extending VAT. And that is absolutely what we've done in previous manifestos.
You ruled out an income tax hike in 2005 and broke that promise.
Sure.
So if you could rule out income tax hike this time, why can't you rule out a hike in VAT?
Because we're not going to go through every tax that there is in the system.
It's pretty substantial taxes.
We made a clear choice on VAT. We made a clear choice on VAT. We had a choice of raising national insurance or raising VAT. And indeed, let me just make this point. We've never had a pledge on VAT on a manifesto since 1997, and nor have we raised it.
No, but basically what we're saying tonight is that it's perfectly possible that if Labour wins, you may hike VAT.
No, I'm not saying that.
Well,
Kirsty.
It is. That is obviously what you must be saying if you're not going to rule it out.
I'm saying we're making pledges consistent with our previous pledges and previous manifestos.
OK, let's talk now about Royal Mail. Not quite clear what's happening about the Royal Mail. Will it remain wholly publicly owned if Labour wins?
I think Peter Mandelson said very clearly today that depends on the plans for modernisation that are part of the Royal Mail. We dropped the previous plans, the plans for part privatisation, for getting private investment into the Royal Mail, partly because of the economic conditions. He said today, I think rightly, that we want to modernise the Royal Mail. We'll obviously have to see what happens
in the next parliament. What he actually said in The World at One was that actually he wasn't resiling on previous ideas of legislation. It was simply because of market conditions.
Well,
is a quote, it is possible that there will be a future part privatisation. So that is not what the manifesto is saying.
Well, I read the transcript of the interview, and he also went on to say that it depended on modernisation of the post office.
So it is possible then that a future Labour government will part privatise the post office?
We'll have to see what happens, but what we're focused on is modernising the Royal Mail, and that's what Peter said today.
Are you middle class?
Am I middle class?
I'm asking.
I was brought up in a middle class household, yes.
So you're middle class? Because I'm just wondering why there's such emphasis on class. I mean, I've never heard Gordon Brown in previous years going about saying that he is middle class. And very definitely, he is putting class on the agenda. Class is going to be a very prominent feature in this campaign. Why are you all talking about class now?
Well, I think there's a very clear choice at this election. We talk about the way we want to reform our economy, society and politics, but there's also a choice about values and who you stand up for at this election.
Well, what makes any difference about values if you're middle class or working class?
Well, who do you stand up for in society? The people on lower and modest incomes. That's what lower and middle incomes. That was what Gordon Brown was talking about today. Now, there is...
And he specifically said, and it did not sound very comfortable coming from his mouth, because it's not the kind of thing that he would in the past have said, I am middle class, And yeah. It is an election ploy, isn't it?
No, it isn't an election ploy. Look, there's big choices about how we cope with scarce resources. Do we have inheritance tax cuts for millionaires, or do we protect tax credits for people on, yes, lower and modest incomes? They are big choices about how we spend scarce resources at this election. So that's the point about class, I think.
Finally, how do you address the problem that there is no real big vision in this? There was your vision in 97. There is no vision in 2010.
I don't agree with that there's no vision, and you might expect me to say that. The vision is very clearly of an economy reshaped and market institutions reshaped by government in the right way to build the strong economy of the future, a fairer society as we go forward, and also a big opening up of our politics. And I think that's a vision.
Ed Miliband, thank you very much.